So a few days ago, I released a video showcasing all of the new improvements to Lightroom Desktop 8.4. But that's not the only surface to get some cool new features. Lightroom Mobile for iOS also got some sweet new improvements that I'd like to show you right now. I'll be using my iPhone 16 Pro Max to show you how to use these new features, and I'm also going to include a bonus feature added to Lightroom Web, so be sure to stick around to the end. All right, let's dive in. All right, so the first thing you'll want to do is make sure you have the latest version of Lightroom installed on your iPhone. To do that, just tap on the App Store, search for Lightroom, and then under What's New, you'll want to make sure, at least for this video, that you have version 10.4 installed. Once it's installed, go ahead and launch Lightroom. Now, the new feature that I'm going to show you that I think is really cool is part of Quick Actions. And so we introduced Quick Actions last October at Adobe Max, October 2024. And just really high level, Quick Actions, if you haven't used them, when you open an image up using Quick Actions, we'll look at the contents of the photo and surface recommended edits based on what we see in the photo. So if there's a person, we'll recommend some portrait edits. If there's like a landscape or a sky or something, we'll recommend edits to the sky. Now, though, there is something new that we added to Quick Actions that I think is really awesome. So here, I'm going to go ahead. You see, I have this photo, and if I tap and hold, this is unedited. I'm going to go ahead and tap on the actions icon on the left of this bottom toolbar. And the new feature is that second icon there called Scene. And actually, when I tap on it, the feature is actually called Scene Enhance. So what does Scene Enhance do? At the very start, Scene Enhance has some pretty awesome and versatile presets. So I'm just going to tap through them here. And you've got Futuristic, Black and White, which is actually a really nice black and white preset. Vintage, which I like. Travel and lifestyle. Now let me go to something like travel here, and you might look at this and say, whoa, you know, this is really strong. And I agree with you. However, there is an amount slider right below it. So if I drag this to zero and then just slowly build it out, somewhere right around here, actually, that's a really nice look. But of course, you know, if you want a different preset, you can try vintage. I also like vintage here. And so, you know, I'll go ahead and kind of make it pretty strong. So something like that. Now, that's not what Scene Enhance is really all about, at least not entirely. Because if I scroll down here, you can see we have all of these other filters. And here's the thing about Scene Enhance, about these specific sliders. The best way to think about it is each slider, each identified component, when you use the slider, what we're trying to do is let you either emphasize or de-emphasize that attribute. So if you drag the slider to the right, that's going to emphasize whatever we detected. And if you drag it to the left, it's going to de-emphasize. So let me show you what I mean. Let's start at the top here with subject. So we identified there's a person here who is the subject, and we automatically made a selection of them. So this is what I mean about moving the slider to the right and left. If I bring the slider to the right, what we're doing is we're applying a certain treatment that emphasizes the subject. And you can see how the subject gets brighter. And if I bring it to the left, it's de-emphasizing the subject. Now, generally, subjects you want to emphasize them, right? So I'm going to bring this out somewhere right around here. And then I'm just going to move down. You can see we have background. So here, if I want to darken everything but the subject, I can. I'm not going to touch background right now. With the sky, again, you can see here, only the sky is either being de-emphasized or emphasized. So something right around here looks really cool because it is a very cool sky. Now here's where things get super cool, because if you remember with Lightroom Desktop version 10.3 that we released in April of this year, we introduced landscape masking. So what that is, it's a series of adaptive masks that looks at an image and attempts to identify certain landscape attributes like mountains and water and natural ground and man-made ground and architecture. And so now we're bringing that functionality to Lightroom Mobile in Scene Enhance. So you can see here we have mountains. This was not something that we had before. And so watch, if I go to the right, see how the mountains get more emphasized? And if I go to the left, you see how by emphasis and de-emphasis, it's all relative here. Basically, they're just getting a little bit flatter, which I don't want. I actually want the mountains to be a little bit darker. Now I'll move down here with vegetation. Same thing, bringing it to the right makes the vegetation pop. and bring it to the left makes it a little bit more subdued. And I actually kind of want that. It's getting a bit too punchy in this image. And then even the artificial ground you can see here, like if I want to darken it just a little bit, something like that looks good. And if I tap and hold, this is the unedited photo. And then, I mean, to me, this looks so much better. It just, again, if I wasn't actually walking you through and narrating you through this process, I can take the image from here to here in seconds. And so really all I would do is just select a preset. If there's one that I like, refine the strength. And then I would go through these sliders here and adjust them. And again, the way that I recommend looking at these sliders is to the right will emphasize and to the left will de-emphasize. And you don't have to use every single slider. Like I didn't use natural ground and I didn't end up using background, and that's fine. Now here's an even cooler thing. When I commit these edits by tapping on the check mark, I can go to the masking panel here and you can see all of those masks have been created. So I can further refine this. Like I can go to the sky selection here and maybe go to effects, maybe pull back on that clarity, then go to color. Maybe I want to warm the sky up. And let's go back to effects one more time. And maybe I'm going to pull back on the dehaze a little bit. And that's really the beauty of quick actions. And the reason why I think they're really great is it serves a purpose for whether you are new to Lightroom and whether you are a pro to Lightroom. Because again, it allows you to get these results. If you didn't know how to mask, you can get these great results just by moving some sliders. But if you want to dive deeper, you can go to the masking panel afterwards and then refine it using the entire editing stack in Lightroom Mobile, which is very, very powerful. And so again, that is how I'm able to edit my image from here to here, just using Scene Enhance as part of Quick Actions. And so again, I really think you should have some fun, experiment with different types of photos and see how those sliders affect using the kind of emphasize, de-emphasize mindset with those adaptive masks. All right, the other new feature that came to Lightroom Mobile is also available in Lightroom Desktop, and I think it's awesome. It's called People Removal. So I took this photo in Brooklyn, I think the Coney Island area, if I remember correctly, many years ago. But let's say, you know, you took this photo, maybe this is your family, and you see all of these people in the background that you'd prefer not to have them there. Well, now it's easy to get rid of them. All you need to do is tap on the remove icon on the toolbar, and you'll see this little circular button with a few people in it. All you have to do is tap on it, and then you'll be prompted to remove extra people. I'm going to go ahead and tap on that. And then Lightroom will start detecting people in the image. And look at that. I mean, you can see all of the different areas that it selected for you. Now, you'll see there's a little suggestion that you can tap on a person if you want to keep them. So let's say, you know, this person there, I actually want to keep them. Well, now you can see that the selection is hollowed out and it's got kind of like a broken line around it. That means that Lightroom will not attempt to remove that area. Of course, you can tap again. And if you decide you want to get rid of it, you can. So now what I'm going to do is tap on this large blue button to start removing those areas. And there you go. That really is impressive. They're just gone and it's a seamless fill. But of course, you can refine any of those areas. So if you tap here, you'll see the button now says refine people. So I'm going to tap on that. And you can see each of the different pins that were selected. So let's say I tap on this one over here. You see you have the option to select three different variations towards the bottom. So if I tap the right arrow, it changes the variation. And I can select the one that suits my needs best. I'll go ahead and tap on done. And again, if I tap and hold, you can see that is the image with all those people. And now we did a Thanos snap and they are gone. There is another button that I want to show you, and it has to do with using these generative AI tools. It's on the top left here. And if I tap on it, you have the ability to choose whether you want to work with reduced resolution images or higher resolution images when using these tools. Now, personally, I prefer using the highest resolution image that I have available no matter what. And so I have it on work with higher resolution. But again, if you're just more conscientious, you don't want to download larger files, or you just want to move faster with these edits, you can work with reduced resolution. So just select the option that you prefer and tap OK. And just remember, when you are done with removing those extra people, you'll want to tap on the check mark on the bottom right to commit that. Again, this is what we started with. And this is how we were able to get rid of those distracting people in just a few seconds. All right, so I mentioned that I also have kind of a new feature to Lightroom Web, and this is a small one, but still a welcome feature, especially because it just further shows how the Lightroom Web team is trying to bring that surface forward. So also last October at Adobe Max, for Lightroom Desktop, we introduced Smart Album support. So Smart Albums are similar to Smart Collections in Lightroom Classic, where you can create an album that fits certain criteria, and if the image fits or meets that criteria, it'll appear in these Smart Albums. So I'm going to create a Smart Album really quickly here. I can do that by going to the plus icon and selecting Create Smart Album. And I'm going to call this 4-star waterfall photos taken in 2017. Actually, no, I'm going to call this 2017 4-star waterfall, just because that was getting long. I'll keep it at the top level, and now I'm going to build out the criteria. So I'm going to click on Add New Rule. I'm going to start with the capture date, and that's in between, so in the range of the 1st of January 2017 to the 31st of December 2017. Then I'll click Add New Rule. I'm going to say that the rating should be 4 stars. And then finally, I can add what I think is one of the best parts of this, why I love using Lightroom Desktop and the entire Cloud Eco, is I can select search, and I can include a search term, even if the image doesn't have keywords or anything like that, even if it doesn't have any descriptors in the metadata, Lightroom will apply intelligent searching to include these images. So I'm going to just type in waterfall, and then I'm going to click on create. And there you go. Here are all the waterfall photos that I took in 2017 that have a 4-star rating. These do not have any sort of keywords or metadata that indicates that it's a waterfall, as you can see here. And so now, if I go to Lightroom Web and I refresh, you can see that the Smart Album is now registered here. So Lightroom Web can now read Smart Albums that you create in Lightroom Desktop. And so those are the new features that were added to Lightroom Mobile and a new feature added to Lightroom Web. Again, I think that all of these surfaces are just getting more and more powerful for a wider range of Lightroom user, which I think is always a good thing. Now, these are just small parts of Lightroom. Lightroom is pretty big and there's a lot to know about it, including everything that goes on in Lightroom Desktop, Lightroom Mobile, and Lightroom Web. So if you want to learn all about that, then please do check out my course called Lightroom Everywhere. I'll leave a link to it in the description below. I also mentioned how there were new features added to Lightroom Desktop version 8.4. I've got this video to show you all that. And of course, if you found this video helpful, thumbs up really helps the channel, as does subscribing and clicking on the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.